Hey guys, just coming at you here with one room of carpet cleaning. It's one of those, I'm just doing one room because it's the worst room in the house. I believe I'm coming back on Friday to clean the rest. Just wanted to know, you know, how, what I could do with this one room, because they wanted to know if I could do some patches in here, and I was like, honestly, there's too much going on here for patches to be cost effective. Best thing is to clean it and do kind of a stain removal and get as much as you can, and if we're still not satisfied with what happened, then probably carpet replacement would be the way to go for this room. But anyway, I'm gonna turn the camera around and show you where I'm starting here, and should make a good video. I've got my wallpaper steamer out. This is supposed to be nail polish. I don't know that that's true, but because when I hit it with ammonia, it started trying to break it apart, and I didn't know ammonia would do that. With, I guess that's acrylic, which is nail polish, I believe. Got all this other here, got all this blue and all this pink nail polish stuff, and probably some of it's makeup. Makeup should come out just fine with ammonia. So basically, I'm gonna be cleaning this with just, you know, your typical hydrogen peroxide and Fabuloso basically today. And then I'm gonna be hitting all of the colored areas and letting it dwell with ammonia, and then I'm going to be adding heat to some of them all before I do the cleaning, just to see what I can make happen. Like over here, this has already been sprayed, so I'm going to put this guy on it, warm it up, and that'll help it release. If it's red dye in it, it'll reverse it, and if it's this needs to be softened up with some heat, it'll help with that too. So basically, I'm gonna go around every inch of the colored stuff in this room and blast it with ammonia and let it dwell and kind of move the heater around on it and see what I can make release. And I'm not billing for stain removal, I'm billing for the cleaning of one room. So, you know, if I was, you know, billing for actual stain removal and stuff, I would probably be charging quite a lot more, but I'm only charging a one room fee for cleaning on this one here. So you've got to, you know, take that in consideration. You know, if I was doing an actual real stain removal, I would probably be spending a whole lot more time with it. But not the case here. We're just gonna see what we can make happen with this here. All right, I'm gonna finish spraying this, and then I'll check back in when I get ready to pre-treat it, probably. All right, about to choke to death on ammonia here. It is softening up. The nail polish is, when you get it, however hot, I've got it. I don't know how hot that is. So when it comes time to clean across all of this, I'm gonna move the iron from each one to the other and see what I can make release. Probably have to put some more. Yeah, that will not be coming out. Ouch! That might. That's pretty hot. All right. Anyway, this is just interesting to see how much I'll be able to take out. And no, this is not cost effective. Pretty cleaner to do. This is basically about a video and just seeing what I can make happen here. For the price I'm charging to do all of this in this room, you would generally stand to lose money. So I wouldn't make it your point to do this everywhere you go. If you have a YouTube channel and you got something to show somebody, then maybe, but otherwise, no. It takes far too much time to earn any money unless you're charging, you know, a certain amount for each stain that you get out. All right, I'm not blown away, but I'm not extremely dissatisfied. It's been brought down now to probably where, you know, I'm gonna discuss with them on the way out, you know, what we wanna do next. Maybe it's worth making two patches, maybe get rid of that red there, maybe three. This red here and that blue, maybe. It just depends. At any rate, we're a lot, we present a lot better than we did before I did this. There's paint everywhere. I had to razor blade some of this stuff out, the big globs of paint. A couple of those over here, I razor bladed out. We got like paint on the wall, and I had to take a chunk out of here, and there's basically nothing left underneath it when you take it out. But I mean, it goes all the way down, but all the way down to the where the fibers attach. So anyway, we're gonna see what they want to do next. I just thought this would make a neat video because I haven't run into a lot of this going on in such a small area in a while. When you have this much in a small area, you have to decide, you know, if you're gonna do repair or replace the whole thing or what. You know, cleaning only goes so far and repair work only goes so far. At some point it becomes necessary to just replace. And I don't know that I could squeeze in a carpet replacement this time of year. If they wanted to do a replacement, I'd probably refer them out to the place where I get all of my carpet from to make my repairs with. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I like to show things that don't turn out quite so well too. That way it doesn't look like I'm stacking up full of easy jobs or something that I only want to share the easy stuff with you guys. Not everything is fixable, and a lot of clients know that. Some clients don't. Be good for the ones that don't to see a video like this, for sure. Anyway, that is it for today. I'm glad I got to make some video. I think when I get home, I'm gonna get the new machine out and talk about that a little bit in a video. All right, guys, thanks for watching, and God bless. I'll see you on the next video.